This is Match Game 74, production number 0219, and it is take one. Get ready to match the stars. Orson Bean, Brett Summers, Charles Nelson Reilly, Abby Dalton, Richard Dawson, and Fanny Flagg as we play the star-studded Big Money Match Game 74. And now, here's the host of Match Game 74, Gene Rayburn.
Get out.
Okay, I'm going. Yeah. Thank you for joining us. Thank you, Johnny Olson.
Bye.
Everybody okay over here?
Yeah.
Yes.
Hardly seems possible. We've only been at sea 3 days.
That's right. And already the shoulders are bare. Well, yeah. What are you going to do? All right, here's our current champ, Karen O'Day, and her challenger, Sean Graff. Let's greet these two ladies. Karen has won $9,650. She's got 3 games under her belt. And we met Sean just as we finished last time and found out that this youthful-looking lady is a mother of a 13-year-old child. And that's really difficult to believe. I'm not going to ask you how old you are.
Thank you.
But you did. What is she? She looks 18.
Yep.
19 at the most. All right.
I love it.
We're going to start a brand new game right after we start a little business with our audience all over America. Here it is. Here we are. Already? Well, I moved your lights there. I'll push this button, ladies. I reveal 2 questions here in round one and ask Sean to make a selection.
Is it B? Oh, yes.
B it is. Here we go. New game, folks.
Yes, it's exciting.
The Lone Ranger said.
Yes.
The reason I never got married is that I've never found a girl who could blank like Tonto. That's what he said. The Lone Ranger said, the reason I never got married is I've never found a girl who could blank like Tonto.
You realize that Orson Welles has made me quick. He's the only one, because when he looks at my answers, he always says, don't use those. That's terrible.
You just made a Freudian slip
you
of the
tongue. You called him Orson Welles.
You called him Orson Welles. And he only weighs 112 pounds.
I'm the skinny Orson.
I'm not telling who I'm dating.
All right. Okay, everybody's set over there. Sean. The Lone Ranger said, the reason I never got married is that I've never found a girl who could blank like Tonto.
Ride?
Who could ride like Tonto? I found a girl who could ride like Tonto. All right.
What did you say?
Who could kiss like Tonto?
Who could kiss like Tonto?
Well, listen, they're out there alone in the prairie for months on end.
That's right.
We mustn't pass judgment.
That's right, Brett.
I took advice from him, right?
You did? Yes.
Thank heavens this time I minded my own business.
Right. One for you, Sean. Charles.
Right is the next one. I said cook like
Tonto. Cook like Tonto is another good answer. Aren't those good answers, Abby?
Yes, Charles and I think a Ride's lot alike.
Really?
Yes, because Tonto and they were very close. Cook.
Cook. Oh. Okay. So we got 2 cooks, and what do you say?
Last cook didn't go over very well.
No.
Oh, that's
They're
it.
Petering
Too many
out on the
cooks
cookie there.
Spoiled
Too,
each
that's
show.
It.
Now, is that right that he rode side saddle?
Who?
Tonto?
Tonto? I don't know.
Something I heard.
Ride. Thank you. Fanny Flagg, it's up to you.
Who was that tall stranger? Well, I'm with Charles. I said cook. Never thought of ride.
Right. All right. Cook was a good answer.
What was Tonto's horse name?
Tonto's horse.
No.
Bullet.
Scout. Get him up, Scout. He was a Palomino. It's when the Lone Ranger said, "Hi-oh, Silver," Tonto would reply, "Get him up, Scout."
Scout.
Isn't that interesting?
What an interesting piece of information.
Better than your thing about the chickens the other day.
All right, are you ready for this? Everybody plays, because this is Karen's first round question. For their 75th wedding anniversary,
yes.
Grandpa and Grandma said, "Give us something useful." So their family gave them his and her blanks.
Oh!
He said, give us something useful. So the family gave him his and her blanks.
Now, don't look at my answer. Mind your own bloody business.
I don't even want to see it when you show it to the audience.
Read it again.
All right. For the 75th wedding anniversary, Grandpa and Grandma said, give us something useful. So their family gave them his and her blanks.
Oh, I'm sorry, Abby. I didn't mean to.
This is kinky, isn't it? It's
like the Did you remove that woman's brassiere?
Let's throw her back. She's too small.
Okay. No, reel her in. What the heck? Okay, everybody ready? Let's find out what answer we get from Karen O'Day. For their 75th wedding anniversary, Grandpa and Grandma said, give us something useful, so their family gave them his and her blanks.
Rocking chairs. Yes.
Rocking
what?
Chairs.
What? What?
Like that. His and her what?
She said, his and her rocking chairs, which is her idea of a useful thing for old people.
Yes.
What do you say is useful for old people?
I said his and her beds. I
didn't beds. Yeah, okay. Don't explain. We understand
better
that.
Better than the first answer.
Okay, Brett, what do you say?
I love my answer.
You love your answer?
You can't say it. Is it his and her divorce papers?
Oh. That's a nice wedding anniversary.
For those of you who laugh, you have good taste in
perception. Is there something on your mind, Brett?
Charles?
I said his and her pep-up pills.
His and her pep-up pills.
I don't think that's
okay. Hello, Granny.
After 75 years, I think that they should have his and her bed.
His and her bed.
That's a match with me.
Yes.
Doesn't she kiss me?
So far, Karen, you haven't scored. His and her, family gave them his and her blanks, and she said rocking chairs, and your answer is?
Well, that'd be a dangerous gift, because if, you know, he fell over, he'd be off his...
rocker. Got it? Okay.
Wheelchairs.
Wheelchairs.
They've been going around together ever since.
What do you say?
I always say, I said rocking chair.
Good job.
Rocking chair. Hey, hey, hey. Oh, that's one. Okay, 2-1 the score at the end of round one, and now we've got a round of messages for you. So you hurry right back for more games. Here we go. Push the button and expose two questions. Our second and final round. Ask Sean to make a decision here.
I have to stick with B.
B was good to you last time, and you think it'll be good this time?
Yeah.
Now, last time you matched two of our celebrities, Brett and Richard. The two of you will lay out, and the rest will participate.
Yes.
Eve said,
yes.
Adam has broken out in a terrible rash. I think it's because he's allergic to blank. Eve said that. Adam has broken out in a terrible rash. I think it's because he's allergic to blank. All right, Orson's ready, and Charles, are you ready? Abby's ready, and Fanny's ready. So I guess we'll just call on Sean for her response. I think it's because he's allergic to...
apples.
Apples. That sounds like a good answer to me. I think that's a very logical answer. Is there some logic to that in your mind?
What then is Adam and Eve? Kumquats? Apples.
Apples it is. There's one there. Charles?
Well, fig leaf would be more fun, but apples.
Apples. Okay. So far, we've got a lot of apples.
I hesitate to think how he got that rash. But it's from fig leaves.
Fig leaves. Okay.
You got it from somebody else.
All right,
Fanny. In Rhode Island.
All right. Now it's your turn, Fanny.
Apple.
Apple. Okay. You're up to five, Sean, and now... there's a little pressure on you here, but you've been in the spot before, Karen. You've got to match four celebrities to stay in the game. Five will win your fourth game. Now, you matched one celebrity last time. It was Fanny, so Fanny, you do not play. At the pet shop, Dumb Dora said to the salesman, if that's a police dog, where's his blank?
Oh, I love that one.
At the pet shop, Dumb Dora said to the salesman, if that's a police dog, where's his blank? All right.
Finally
everybody ready up there. Mm. And everybody ready down here. Karen O'Day, at the pet shop. Dumb Dora said to the salesman, if that's a police dog, where's his blank?
His badge.
His badge.
What?
Where's his badge? Let's see, now you need four badges to tie. Five badges will win a game. Orson.
The entire O'Day family is in paroxysms of joy. Badge, yeah.
Badge. You got all your cousins and everybody out here rooting for you. You brought a whole clack here.
She
Brett.
Had a lot of relatives.
She's got two husbands out there alone.
Oh, excuse me.
What?
She had a lot of friends and relatives out there.
Yeah.
I thought I finally caught myself. This time I really got a winner. Uniform.
Uniform. Uh-oh. Gotta match everybody else to stay in the game. Charles, badge is her answer.
As a foremost acting teacher, I have found that I can get a very terrific reaction with just the turn of a hand. I should have acted that better.
Yes.
All right. Sweetheart.
All right, badge is the answer she's looking for, and she's got to match you and Richard to stay in the game.
He was a streaking police dog, and he was just wearing a badge.
Just wearing a badge.
Oh, it's going
well,
to be
again, you're in that spot, Richard. You're going to be a good guy or a bad guy?
Badges?
Badge.
I ain't got no badges.
What do you got?
Badger.
You got badges. So, this game ends in a tie, and we'll wipe the slate clean and go to a tiebreaker.
Attention,
one question for each lady. Sean, you make the selection.
Well, I'm fickle. A.
A. All right, you've been with B a couple of times, now you're going with A. Everybody plays.
Okay.
Colonel Sanders said...
Yes.
Colonel Sanders said, I had a terrible nightmare last night. I dreamed a giant chicken tried to blank me. That's what Colonel Sanders said. I had a terrible nightmare last night. I dreamed a giant chicken tried to blank me.
I know I've got it this time. I know it like I know my right
name. I know you've got it.
I know
it. I'm taking something for it.
Come on, there's only one answer here.
That's true.
No, there's another answer. The Colonel had that dream another night. Luckily, it wasn't this.
No, there are a couple of good... Well, the questions are written so that there is usually more than one good answer, but Orson, what are you doing? Artwork?
Orson!
We don't need the artwork. Just do a simple answer and stick it in the slot there. Okay, all set? All right. Now, Sean, we call on you. Colonel Sanders said, I had a terrible nightmare last night. I dreamed the giant chicken tried to blank me.
Pluck.
Pluck?
Pluck me.
Oh, let it go.
Yeah. I'm sorry.
She said a giant chicken tried to pluck me.
That was the other dream I was talking about, but in this one, he ate him.
Eat is the answer, yeah.
That now, do you see why I took so much time?
That's beautiful.
Thank you.
Gee, look at that fancy three-dimensional losing answer there. Brett, what did you say?
P.U.
You don't like that?
I don't even like his artwork. I feel that's a terrific answer. It is a terrific answer.
Well, I think eat is a better answer.
Eat?
Yeah.
Is better than pluck?
No. Yes.
No, pluck is terrific. I said fry.
Fry, it'd be good, too.
That's my second.
I thought I had it.
All right.
I thought it was better than uniform.
Third, yes. Charles?
I said sell.
Sell. I'm amazed at so many answers coming up here. What do you offer?
Well, it was really a toss-up between eat and pluck, and I would rather...
Eat. All right. Okay. What do you say?
Well, I didn't have the pluck not to write eat.
You didn't have the pluck not to write eat. He's a plucky fellow, this Englishman here, isn't he?
Very kind. Thank
yes.
You.
What do you say there?
No, well, Colonel Sanders had his little legs eaten.
Okay. All right, so you didn't do well with that at all, and we've got a question for you, and you're in a good spot, because all you need is one to win another game. But first, before that happens, let this happen.
Today's consolation prizes are a solid maple butcher block serving cart by Costco. Artistry, new distinctive serving carts, that's no stranger, that's the Costco. And Ace Paint, that can create fashion magic in your home with the latest in color selection from Ace Hardware stores all over America. And Woodcrafter Furniture Polish to give you real paste wax shine and protection. Woodcrafter, hand rough beauty in a spray. Will you join me, please, when Match Game 74 continues in 1 minute?
Here we go. Second half of our tiebreaker. Sean did not score. Karen, that means one match will win another game for you. That'll be your fourth game. Everybody plays. When Cheap Charlie heard a new phonograph needle was going to cost $20,
yes,
he tried to play the records with his blank. I don't write them. I just read them here. When Cheap Charlie,
yes,
heard a new phonograph needle was going to cost $20, he tried to play the records with his blank.
Yes. No more braggadocio from me. Or is it dashio?
Yes. Just helping out. A little spelling there. Okay, but spelling doesn't count as long as we get the idea here. We all set over there. Okay. Carolyn O'Day, when Cheap Charlie heard a new phonograph needle was going to cost $20, he tried to play the records with his...
Fingernail, yeah.
Yeah, I would have said that, too. Sounds like a good answer to me. One fingernail wins a game, Orson.
Yes, his screams emanated from the room with the pencil sharpener in it. His fingernail.
Congratulations. There's another 100 for you, 97.50. And Sean, we've got to say goodbye to you. It's been a real pleasure meeting you. You're a very pretty lady. And we've got a gift for you backstage. Sean
Graff. Thank you. It's been great fun. Thank you all.
Thank you. Well, here we go again, Karen. Don't keep backing up. Stay with me because you're going to have a go at over $5,000 here. Shall we begin?
Okay.
We polled a recent studio audience. We got their best response to this. Blank helper. Now, the answer they gave most often is worth $500 if you match it. If you match the next one, it's $250 and the third $100. Which celebrities would you like a little help from?
Abby.
Abby, what do you say about that?
Hamburger.
Hamburger helper?
Shows how my kids eat.
Hamburger helper.
Yes,
okay, that's one answer.
Fanny?
Mother's Little Helper.
Mother's Little Helper. Isn't that thrilling? Okay, that's two.
Richard?
They never belong.
What me. Billy Barty is in the off-season. Santa's Helper.
Santa's Helper.
Why don't they ever call
So you got Hamburger's
answer.
Helper, Santa's
answer.
Helper, and Mother's Little Helper.
That was a real good answer.
Do you want one of those, or do you want to give us one of your own? What would you like to do?
Go for Hamburger Helper.
You go for Hamburger Helper? I go for Hamburger Helper, too.
All right.
But let's get back to the game. Okay. Hamburger Helper is the one we're looking for, and let's find out if it's up there, and if so, where. First, may we see the $100 response? Santa's Helper is the one that Richard gave you?
Not for me, for Billy Barty. Folks.
Yeah, all right.
Thank you.
Hamburger Helper, are you there under the $250 response?
Nope.
Hamburger Helper is there.
You're
going
to see.
Now look at that $500. What do you think is under there?
Mother's helper.
Mother's
no
helper.
Little. Just mother's
Just
helper.
Just mother's helper. All right, let's find out right
mother's
now.
Mother's helper.
Here it is.
Mother's helper.
Mother's helper. All right. That would have won.
Very nice.
Okay, now Karen, you know you've got the $250. That's yours. That gives you an even $10,000.
Wow.
You're going to be playing for 10 times $250 or $2,500. Remember to collect. You've got to match one celebrity. Time to choose one.
Can I stay with Richard?
I don't know.
Oh,
have you got room?
Richard.
You must be out by 9 a.m., darling.
Yes.
I have a cleaning woman who comes in.
Yes.
Terrible gossip.
You are.
Okay, you get ready to write. You face me if you would, Karen. And here is the $2,500 question. Blank fight. F-I-G-H-T. Finished. Okay. What answer do you come up with in order to match Richard in this fill-in? Blank fight.
Pillow fight.
Pillow fight. No? Well, I don't know. They're awing you a little bit there. He may not let you stay if you're going to get, you know. All right, Richard, for $2,500, may we see your answer?
Well, we did have a great run, didn't we?
Right.
I have dog fight, though.
Dog fight. You know, there's some...
Heel.
Pillow fight, dog fight, fist fight. A lot of good choices here. It was a tough one.
I would have said pillow, Karen.
You would have said pillow fight.
I would have said
didn't call on her, but you did pillow. Okay, no hard feelings. Karen and Dave still got the even $10,000, and you're going to meet another player. So here comes Diane Jones. You know Karen O'Day? How, well, tell us about this pretty lady, Diane Jones.
Oh.
You remember Diane Jones?
Yeah. First, I'm a dental assistant. I'm single, no kids.
Yeah. I think you told us enough.
Not bad.
Two out of three is not bad.
Tell the good stuff first, Diane. Yes.
I live with my mother and father. And
that's
it.
A lot of laughs. Yeah. Okay. All right, I'll push a button here and ask you, the challenger, Diane, to make a selection.
A, please.
A. All right. A is what she wants, and here it is. Dr. Frankenstein said to the tailor, "Could you make for my monster a nice blue suit? He needs it for his blank." Dr. Frankenstein said to the tailor, "Could you make for my monster a nice blue suit? He needs it for his blank." All right. Everybody ready?
I'm ready.
Quickly.
I'm ready.
Ready. Diane. Dr. Frankenstein said to the tailor, "Could you make for my monster a nice blue suit? He needs it for his..."
Funeral.
Funeral. Well, I guess that's in keeping with everything else she's told us so far. Orson, may we see your answer?
Well, from the accent you used for Dr. Frankenstein, he needs it for his monster's bar mitzvah.
Bar mitzvah. Maybe I misled you there. Brent, what do you say?
I got so unnerved, I said wedding.
The wedding.
Yeah.
All right, yeah. Charles.
Thank you,
it
sweetheart.
It was the bar mitzvah.
It was indeed. Was it a bar mitzvah, Andy?
You bet. Where else would he wear a blue suit?
That's just a blue suit.
It's hard to say it wasn't. It was a wedding.
It was a wedding. And what do you say?
A bar mitzvah.
Okay, so Diane, that's your question in the first round, and we just don't have time for yours, Karen, but we do have time for this, and you listen to this and you come back. I want to say thanks to all the ding-a-lings and hope you'll join us next time for Match Game 74, Gene Raven. Goodbye.
This is Johnny Olsen speaking for Match Game 74, a Mark Goodson, Bill Todman production.